Abba Yahweh, I come before you just as I am. I'm sorry for my sins and I repent of my sins. Please forgive me. Please forgive me of all the sins I committed by thought, deed, and action, past, present, and future, in the name of Yahawashah HaMashiach. Save Yasharal from all of your daily judgments, and I pray that you continue to count us worthy to be delivered from your wrath to come. Keep us refreshed in your Ruach HaKodesh and continue to rain judgment upon the heathens in the here and now. May Yahweh Rapha, mercy and blessings continue upon all of Yasharal, chosen and grafted. Thank you for Matzah the Lamb, the Ruach HaKodesh, the Pachimama, and all of the Erkadeshi watching over Yasharal. Hallelujah. The increase in knowledge now upon the earth with all the races of men is only the increase I gave. Man of himself created none of it. Neither can thou create one thought, nor idea, nor impulse. Thou can only gather together from my harvest or from me in person. Two kinds of voices have I, saith Jehovah, the silent voice and the audible voice. All men I created susceptible to one or the other of my voices, and many to both. One man hears my voice in the breeze and in thunder and in music. Another hears my voice in the flowers of the field and in the scenery of the mountains. And yet another feels my inspiration, and he skips up the mountainside, and he tires not on the way. He that neither sees nor feels my inspiration goes up the mountain in great labor. In proportion as man is clear in his corporeality and in his spirit, so discerns he my inspiration. And if he have great purity as well, then he shapes my light into corporeal worlds. These I taught man to call my revealed words. Nevertheless, no corporeal man created I perfect, neither can any man reveal my words perfectly. That's saying a lot right there. But I created the way open unto all men to try to reveal me. According to man's approximation to perfect manhood, so reveal I unto him by my presence and my words. According to man's imperfection in manhood, so do not my inspiration manifest on his senses. Perfect manhood created I possible in equal corporal and spiritual senses. That's balance. Hallelujah. Strong corporal senses and weak spiritual senses detract man from my presence and make him infidel to my person. Such a man denies my inspiration and the inspiration of my angels. He is little more than a forest tree, which has a trunk and many branches, but moves not from its place. Shalom, family. You know, I can, as many as, you know, all of us have been called out of the church system, I can just look back with joy and just, you know, just give praise to the Most High Yahweh for delivering us from such a, you know, wicked and dangerous, spiritually dangerous situation. You know, it's sad to see people who are still in these religions, religious institutions, stuck with that strong delusion. It's sad to see them continue to be destroyed even after you reveal the truth to them. You know, they just feel and just believe that what they're doing is right, and you know, it's such a traditional thing to you know, to live on, but it looks good. It's like pastries, you know what I mean? It looks good, but it's actually bad for you. And you know, I just pray to the Most High Yahweh that, you know, the nation will continue to the nation of Yasharela will continue to expose the things that people find so popular to do by going to these buildings, you know, no matter if it's, you know, celebrating the holidays and all that stuff, or just trying there just to get their little feel good on, you know, maybe it's the organ or something. I don't know. Maybe the organ's probably the the reason why they come and go back. It's just something else, man, you know. But I pray that the Most High will continue to wake our people up, you know. All right, so Paul mentions the word Cretan in the scriptures. I believe it was it's the book of Titus, chapter 1, which we'll go over in a little while. But so I wanted to check out what that word meant, because I came across this word a while ago. The Most High showed me, and so it was it came upon my heart to research what this word meant, or, you know, get these perceptions of what this word means, you know. All right, so let's check out the middle portion here, part of it. Back before Cretan meant a stupid person, it was a medical term for a physical deformity that came from a specific disease. Surprisingly, the root of Cretan is the Swiss-French word. All right, the etymology of the same word. From French, Cretan, idiot. From Creston, an Alpine dialect of, or a form of, Cretan. From Latin, Christianus, in the lost sense of anyone in Christendom, often with a sense of poor fellow, a doublet of Christian. Another similar word in the scriptures is Nicolaitism. Nicolaitism, also Nicolaitianism. Was an early Christian sect mentioned twice in the book of Revelation of the New Testament. The adherents were called Nicolaites. They were considered heretical by the mainstream early Christian church, according to Revelations 2:6 and 15. They were known in the cities of Ephesus and Pergamum. In this chapter, the church at Ephesus is endorsed for hating the works of the Nicolaites, which I also hate, and in the church in Pergamus is rebuked. So thou hast also some worshipping in their midst who hold the teaching of the Nicolaites. All right, back here in the first page of the OWASP, I'm going to read chapter 1, verses 11 through 14. And the beast divided itself into four great heads, and possessed the earth about, and man fell down and worshipped them. And the names of the heads of the beast were Brahman, Buddhist, Christian, and Mohammedan. And they divided the earth and apportioned it between themselves, choosing soldiers and standing armies for the maintenance of their earthly aggrandizement. Verse 13. And the Brahmins had 7 million soldiers, the Buddhists 20 million, the Christians 7 million, and the Mohammedans 2 million, whose trade was killing man. And man, in service of the beast, gave 1/6 of his life and his labor to war and standing armies, and 1/3 of his life he gave to dissipation and drunkenness. This was the sixth era. Jehovah called to man to desist from evil, but man heard him not, for the cunning of the beast had changed man's flesh, so that his soul was hid as if in a cloud, and he loved sin. Keeping it moving, you know, keeping it moving. We're going to see where we end up at. Reveal some more stuff, you know. OWASP, the Book of Judgment. Neither shall the Brahmin, nor Mohammedan, nor Buddhist, nor Christian, they spell Christian with a K here, join in the second resurrection on earth or in heaven. Verse 28, for they have not the doctrine of unit. They are as a house divided against itself, their colonies and communities shall fail in all cases. They shall fail in all cases. Man, they're getting jacked up, man. They're getting destroyed. All right, chapter 3, verse 15. And whoso saith Christ, Christ, signifying a God in a figure and shape of a man sitting on a throne in heaven, is a blasphemer against Jehovah, the Creator, the All Person. All right. Verse 30. Wherein the Christians have suffered a people to fall from knowledge into ignorance, or from virtue into vice, my judgment is against them. Oh, yes, it is. Burning churches, people claiming that they, you know, they call themselves Christians, but they end up getting jacked up, you know, one way or another, you know, but yet they keep going back to these religious experiences. Like, again, I think it's that organ, man. Maybe that organ is the heartbeat to their religion. I don't know, but you know, they're just, and they never question themselves, why are they going through this, you know? Study to show thyself approved of the Most High Yahweh, you know? Has to be done, man. So let's go right here to the book of Titus. Chapter 1, let's look at, all right. Start at verse 10. For there are many unruly and vain talkers and deceivers, especially they of the circumcision, whose mouths must be stopped, who subvert whole families or whole houses, teaching things which they ought not for filthy lucre's sake. One of themselves, even a prophet of their own, said, the Cretans are always liars, evil beasts, slow bellies. This witness is true. Wherefore rebuke them sharply, that they may be sound in the belief. All right, right here, we're going to go to Revelation chapter 2, verses 4 through 6. Nevertheless, I have somewhat against you, because you have left your first love. Remember, therefore, from whence you are fallen, and repent and do the first works, or else I will come unto you quickly and will remove your menorah out of its place, except you repent. But this you have, that you hate the deeds of the Nicolaitans, which I also hate. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Ruach says unto the called out assemblies. To him that overcomes will I give to eat of the tree of life, which is in the midst of the paradise of Yahweh. Verses 13 through 16. I know your works and where you dwell, even where Satan's seat is. And you hold fast my name and have not denied my belief, even in those days wherein Antipas was my believing martyr, who was slain among you where Satan dwells. But I have a few things against you, because you have there them that hold the doctrine of Balaam. Remember that name, Balaam, who taught Balak to cast a stumbling block before the children of Yasharal, to eat things sacrificed unto idols and to commit fornication. So have you also them that hold the doctrine of the Nicolaitans, which thing I hate. Repent, or else I will come unto you quickly and will fight against them with the sword of my mouth. Here in the sealed portion, we see the revealing, the flat-footed revelation of the conversation with John the Revelator and Yahawashah. All right, the raw uncut. All right, chapter 65. And now I would that you should understand that after the apostles of the Lord had been killed, and the Gentiles had set up many different churches among them, and many of them claiming to be the true church of Christ, yet even after these things had been done, those that were the true saints of God were cast out of the churches of the rich, even by those men who were rich and powerful, and who had set themselves up as leaders of the people who had the authority of God, which they believed that their leaders had received by the laying on of hands from the direct line of priesthood, which was given unto Peter, James, and John by the Lord. and the true saints of God who were his elect were persecuted and slain by the hands of the Romans and by the consent of those leaders of the Christian faith who had made alliances with the Romans and the other governments of the earth. Yeah, that causes for a Selah right there. All right, let's go down to verse 5. But the churches began to become corrupt and followed not the gospel of Christ, but followed the counsels of men who had set themselves up above the people as the mouthpieces of God, even those who were the bishops and evangelists and the elders of the churches. But as the church corrupted itself, these leaders began to cast out all of those who questioned their authority. Can't even question them, see that? Or who committed a sin according to their own commandments, which were the commandments and precepts of men. And it came to pass that because the church began to embrace the world and teach for commandments the doctrines of men, Satan began to reward the church and its leaders and give unto them the prosperity and power, and power that he gives unto all those who follow him. There goes your prosperity gospel right there. That's your Creflo dollars, your KC prices. All right. Doug Batchelor. Kenneth Copeland, the airplane man. Joel Osteen. Verse 24. And in not too many years, the church became rich and powerful. And when Satan saw that he now had complete control over the church, he left the governments of men that he had set up to control the hearts and desires of the children of men and gave his power and attention to the church, which became great and powerful, even a worldwide church, which being interpreted is Catholic. Christians and Catholics are one and the same. Same umbrella, same institution. And it was some of the leaders of this church that ordered that all the scriptures that were read concerning the life and ministry of Christ should be brought before them, and they might determine that which they would canonize and give unto the world as the official doctrine of Christ. All right, now see, the Bible as we know it is just a select number of books compiled into one volume. All right, there's many more writings than that. Verse 27, and when they had chosen these things, they excluded many things that did not agree with their own doctrines and principles, believing that the records had been corrupted by those who first wrote them. But these records were not corrupted, but were given in their purity by many of the apostles, who were eyewitnesses to the life and ministry of Christ and the words which he spoke. But because these pure words of the apostles did not agree with the corrupted doctrine of the great church, these leaders deleted those things which did not agree with them. Thus were the plain and precious parts of the gospel lost among men. And they would have been lost forever had not the Lord foreseen these things and prepared this record that it might come forth to give once more unto the children of men the things that were taken out of that which he had suffered to be written concerning his gospel. For the original documents that were written by the hands of the apostles were destroyed, and various translations of their words survived, and it was from these documents that survived that the leaders of the church took their official version of the New Testament of the Bible, which you have before you. And there was none who could stand against Satan and the power that he gave unto the church. For the leaders of all nations were chosen by Satan and became his followers. Wow. And great and powerful kings and queens who were ordained and confirmed by the church and its leaders ruled and reigned over the people, perpetuating the works and will of Satan throughout the whole earth. Wow, if you can't see that, I don't know what's wrong with you, man. All right, chapter 71, verse 11. For they shall change the words of Christ and misinterpret them and begin to live their lives according to the commandments which they shall receive from their God, who is Lucifer. And by the words of Christ, they shall not abide. And any who do abide by the words of Christ shall be mocked and persecuted, and judged that these works of Christ, which they do, are the works of the devil, the true Christ being the devil unto the world according to the convincing power that Satan hath over them. Verse 28, and the Lord condemned the seed of Satan, according to the words of John, specifically denouncing the works of they who hold the doctrine of who? Balaam or Bilam, same person. They just tried to spell it the way it sounds. But the doctrine of Bilam, which was the doctrine that was passed down by Benelli through Cain. The Spanish Inquisition, the KKK, murderers for Christ, murderers for Jesus. Shoot, you might as well add in there the police force killing Yasharela, the true Hebrews, the Negro, killing for Cain. You guys, you're in a Cain religion. And you know, Cain, you know, he's the scholar of the first sin, murder, murderer. Wow, man. And behold, the leaders of this great nation shall also follow the ways of the Nicolaitans and follow the course of Balaam, which was passed down to them from one generation of the earth to the other from Benelli and Cain, who first established this order of government among the children of men. We're going to talk about the government. All right. And ye have your Republicans and your Democrats, your presidents and vice presidents and senators and congressmen, and all those who support the principles of Satan, which are principles of the rich ruling over the poor and taking advantage of one another because of the blessings of wisdom and power that they have received from their God, who is Satan. All right, 43. And the people of this nation, like unto the Romans, shall believe that their nation is a nation united under God, and that it cannot be divided or conquered because of its great armies and navies. And it shall deceive the people into believing that it offered liberty and justice for all. Now even these words which I have written shall be the pledge of allegiance to this nation, that those who worship this nation shall say with their own mouths. And with this pledge they deceive themselves and know not that they are pledging their allegiance to Satan. And this they do because they have his mark in their right hands and in their foreheads, and have denied the true words of Christ, and follow after a God and a Christ that have been given unto them by Satan. For he is the great deceiver and the beast and the false prophet, who shall issue forth the flattery of his words unto the people, even those words that the people will accept. If you pledge allegiance to the flag, you're accepting Satan as your mark. If you're celebrating 4th of July, you're accepting Satan as your mark. 4th of July, standing up for the flag. Hand over your heart. Crazy stuff, man. All right, verse 46. And I have seen the flag which this great nation shall raise in its land to show unto the earth the works which it has done. And the people shall worship this flag as a representation of the standard that they have accepted for themselves. And the flag shall be white, symbolizing the righteousness that is claimed of this nation. And this righteousness shall be stained with the blood of the righteous, whom it persecutes, and also of its own sons, who have ignorantly fought that this standard might prevail over all other standards of the earth. And this blood shall be symbolized on their flag as red stripes that lay over the backgrounds of righteousness that it proclaims. And in the corner thereof, there shall be stars which represent the people, even according to the words of John, which he wrote, saying, and his tail drew the third part of the stars of heaven and did cast them down to the earth. And these stars shall be of the white background, or of the righteousness that they have proclaimed in and of themselves, but they shall be found and a field of darkness, which symbolizes the great deception and ignorance of the people who honor and pledge allegiance to this flag. All the people being in darkness and in captivity by the chains of Satan. Behold, Satan can most assuredly bless a nation with wealth and security from other nations and give unto the people of a nation a great sense of patriotism and respect for their nation. And this he accomplishes through the emotions of their hearts. But the people of this nation of Satan shall not love one another according to the words of Christ. And because they cannot love one another, they shall never find the peace and happiness that they desire. The Knights Templar that I mentioned earlier, the poor fellow soldiers. Something else, man. Murderers. We see right here, Nicolaisium with the same rhythm as Brainwash and Fraternal. Here's Knights Templar. Operative Mason. Look at that. Operative. Let's look at the second one. A person who works secretly for an organization. Secret society. Who was Tubal Cain? Let's find out. Let's find out. Genesis chapter 4. We're going to look at verse 22. And Scylla, she also bore Tubal Cain, an instructor of every artificer in brass and iron. And the sister of Tubal Cain was Naamah. But let's look at 21 right quick. And his brother's name was Juval. He was the father of all such as handle the harp and organ. Because that church organ, man, that's why they have it in there. That organ, man. Whew. Tubal Cain is the maker of sharp weapons and the ruling force of Arab Zarak on the tree of Cliffoth. He is the patron of blacksmiths, crafts, and metalworks, the forger of all instruments of bronze and iron, and the maker of weapons and tools of war and destruction. He is also an alchemist and holds the secret transmutation of metals, and in a metaphorical sense, transmutation of the soul on the path of self-destruction. Wow. Weapons of self-destruction. The murder weapons, the murder tools, still doing it today, man, from swords to guns. Those higher ups in the Masonic lodges, they know what they're doing, man. They know what's going on. It's just the people on those initiate levels, they don't know too much about it unless they do their research, you know. But that's Tubal's cane. That's Tubal Cain's. Those are his symbolisms right there. You can check this out. You know, Tubal Cain is the god of all religion. Before Nimrod. Nimrod just carried the tradition. And then from Nimrod, you know, the modern Nimrods today would be the popes. Jubal. Master of the organ, Tubal Cain, was the one forging the weapons. That's murder music. Wow, man. Getting those organs ready, man. I know that organ sound is what, I don't know, I guess that just brings certain people back to those church houses, man. I'm so glad the Most High turn me around and wash me clean from that mess. In music, the organ is a keyboard instrument of one or more pipe divisions or other means for producing tones. Each played with its own keyboard, played either with the hands on a keyboard or with the feet using pedals. Pipe organs use air moving through pipes to produce sounds. people be standing up at attention with that when that thing is going off, you know? Look at that anvil. That anvil is the symbol of the cane. Some wild stuff, man. Some wild stuff. Yep, he is the true God of Christianity and all these other religions out here, man.
I have a domestic violence case. This guy assaulted the same woman 6 times, and she's swearing out an affidavit for non-prosecution.
Have you heard of Tim Poorhouse?
No. What's that?
It's a shelter for lightly battered women.
Funny. That's funny. Turn on a light, they run like roaches.
You work here?
That's what I do.
Jesse Salinas, supervising attorney.
Roman J is ruling the new guy.
Did you just compare us to roaches?
There's no tiptoeing into this.
We're just blown off steam.
You're tourists.
See you around, Israel. See you around, Israel.